Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm sharing a flower card with a really unique stamp set, and this is actually part of a blog hop as we celebrate the June release by Altenew. You will find tons of inspiration and lots of giveaways in this blog hop, so make sure to visit my blog to find all about it. Now, if you want to take a close-up look on all the products that have been released for this month, there is a video that I filmed and you will find it linked at the end of this one. For my card today, I will be using this beautiful stamp set and the matching dies. This is called Sweetest Peas and I really love the designs, so unique, unlike anything that I already have in my stash, and I love the whimsical look on them. Now, I can predict that this is going to be a sellout, so if you like these, make sure to grab them quickly. Now I'm going to do some stamping, and as you can see, this has a really long stem, which means that if I don't stick it correctly down on my paper, I won't be able to use the die on top. So the trick that I always do is to use the die and place the stamp on top of it, and now I can close the window and grab the stamp with the door of my stamping platform. Now I'm going to do the stamping and I will be using black archival ink to color everything because I am planning to use my Zig Clean markers to color my images. By the way, I'm working on Bristol paper, which is super smooth and works great with your Zig markers. Now for the green part of my flowers, I will be using just two different shades of green, and you can see which ones I'm using on your screen right now. I'm blending the colors directly on my paper without using any water at all. Now the second flower is ready. I'm going to fill in the small little part in the third flower, and then I will go ahead and use a wet brush, just slightly wet, and I'm going to touch different areas of these green parts. Not everywhere. This is going to help me lift a little bit of color and create some highlights here and there. For coloring my petals, again, I'm using only two markers and I'm blending them directly on the paper. You can see which colors I used on your screen right now. The idea here is that I am using the darkest marker at the base of each petal, and at the end of the petal, I'm using the light pink one. And I colored all the rest of the petals in the same manner, and again, I lifted a little bit of color with my wet brush at the end to create the highlights. Now I will work a little bit on my background, so for that I'm going to use a new stamp set. This is called Pinstripe stamp set, and it comes with this huge clear stamp with stripes. This is one of those stamps that you will be using again and again, since it comes with these lovely stripes that you can use for pretty much any card, really versatile. And as you can see, hopefully you can see here, that it comes with sentiments such as thank you and hello. Now, I didn't even bother to peel off the stamp from the packaging. I just applied a little bit of embossing ink on one side of this. And now I'm going to apply some gold embossing powder. Now, as you can see, I wanted to have this organic look, kind of archy looking at one side. So that's why I didn't use any masking tape, to have a completely straight line there. And what I love about this stamp is that those stripes are really, really thin and very close to each other, so it is the perfect subtle look for a background. Now it's time to put my card together, so I'm working directly on my card base, and I'm using a strip of this washi tape. This is gold glitter washi tape. And here is Ginger saying hi. Somehow he got interested in my washi tape. So anyway, I am going to stick this on one side of my card, and then on top I'm going to stick my panel. I'm going to use my paper trimmer to chop off a little bit from the panel so that when I place it on top I can still see the washi tape underneath. I'm using foam tape at the back of this panel so that it is a little bit raised. And now it's time to place my flowers on top. You can see that I have already cut out everything. I used the matching dies for that. And I'm going to play around a little bit with those, decide where everything is going to go. Once I was happy with the layout, I took a photo, and then I added some foam squares at the back of the flowers, and I'm adding white glue at the back of the stems. So these flowers, when I stick them on my card, they are going to be dimensional at the top, but the stems are going to be completely flat and secured all my card. Now, if I had to pick just one stamp set out of the whole release, which I absolutely love, I would definitely pick this one. I just love the whimsical look on these flowers. Look how gorgeous they are. Now, I am embellishing my card with a few crystals in gold, so everything matches nicely. And as you can see, I have already stamped the sentiment that says thank you in bold. There are many sentiments in this stamp set, such as thank you are the sweetest, congratulations, hello my sweet friend, and this design is quite versatile, so it could go perfectly fine with pretty much any sentiment. And that completes the card for today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Here are some close-up photos on the card that I made today and those gorgeous flowers. Make sure to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. And here is a link to the video where you can see a close-up look on all the products released by Altenew for June. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.